going on, TTC? You know, I spent all off season debating whether or not to do this video, and it's literally come down to the day before we kick off against North Carolina for me to decide, and I said, fuck it, I'll do it. But let's start off with a couple games from last night. I'm sorry, I couldn't even get through that first sentence without laughing. Tennessee and Appalachian State. Yeah, that's what national champions are supposed to look like, I'm guessing. A couple stats for you. Let's see, Cox actually outrushed Hurd, and he had less carries. I think it was 115 to 110, but, you know, Cox did have less carries than Hurd and still fucking outrushed him. Let's see, Dobbs ended up with, I think, 192 passing yards, one touchdown, and one pick. Didn't look that impressive, and y'all got lucky as fuck on that fumble. That shit looked like some shit Auburn would have done a couple years ago. Y'all on that bullshit. Quite frankly, I thought Appalachian State actually outplayed Tennessee. Tennessee had no business winning that fucking game. I mean, it is what it is. I mean, this is what happens when you motherfuckers run your mouth all off season and you come out and you fucking suck. You know you're gonna fucking hear it. I've been letting Tennessee fans have it on Facebook, so the ones that are on here, yeah, you know you're gonna get it too. I mean, you motherfuckers look like straight ass juice. And then let's talk a little bit about the South Carolina Vanderbilt game. Well, you know, I did see that as a low scoring game. I didn't see no fucking 40 to 30 or some shit. I didn't expect no high score like that. But you know, I actually predicted Vanderbilt to win that game. Of course, I was wrong. For a while, it actually looked like Vanderbilt was going to win that game. But, you know, Vanderbilt being Vanderbilt found a way to blow the shit. But, you know, their defense looks, you know, pretty legit. But there again, I mean, anybody that's expecting Vanderbilt to do much this year, I mean, you need to have your fucking head checked. I mean, South Carolina is projected to have a pretty bad defense. They're not going to be that good. And Vanderbilt could only muster up 10 points on that trash-ass defense. So, I mean, for those that ask, oh, well, was South Carolina that bad or was just Vandy that good? Ah, fuck that shit, man. Both of you motherfuckers are trash. Now, on to the game tomorrow. Georgia versus North Carolina. You know, I actually think this is going to be a good game. For those that think it's going to be a blowout, no. North Carolina does have an offense that can be lethal. Unlike Tennessee fans, I'm realistic. North Carolina does have an offense capable of competing with the best offenses in the nation. That's just the way it is. Their running back, I want to say Elijah Hood or something like that. The dude's pretty legit. He's pretty good. They are replacing their quarterback. He's not, from what I've read about him, what's his name, Trubisky or something like that. He's nowhere near as mobile as the other guy. I hear he's got a, you know, pretty good arm, but I think North Carolina's offense, from what I watched last year, I think it ran, you know, mostly on the run. I think the quarterback not being as mobile will hurt them. I don't think they'll be as an effective offense as they was last year, but they're still going to be good. So don't get me wrong, they're still going to be fucking good. Their defense, though, is another story in general. Their defense, I'm not really worried about their defense. I think Nick Chubb, I mean, well, it's already been said, Nick Chubb is a full go. So he's fucking playing. So you North Carolina fans that didn't think he was going to play, get that shit out of your fucking head. Nick Chubb is playing. Last I checked, I think the story on Sonny Michel, I think it's pretty much going to be a game-time decision with him. He is doing drills in practice, and he's running around, he's doing cuts and all that stuff, but the main issue with it is with his arm he broke. I don't know how much playing time he's going to get, but I actually expect him to play. I mean, I don't know. Just from what I'm hearing with him practicing, I think he's going to play. But if he doesn't, you know, we still got Elijah Holyfield. I'm anxious to see this guy. We still got Brendan Douglas, Tay Crowder. So, I mean, we got options, guys. We got options in the backfield. And it's already been said Grayson Lambert's going to start, but I guarantee you motherfuckers that Jacob Eason is going to fucking play. At the end of the day, I see this game being 30. I'm predicting Georgia to win 30-20. I think this is going to be a high-scoring game. I could be wrong on the score prediction. I could be fucking wrong. Could be 40-30 or some shit. I don't know. But it's going to be a good game. I do think we're going to win. But yeah, this is my first video of the year. I know I didn't really do shit during the off-season. Didn't really want to, really. I just didn't feel up to it. Off-season gets boring. And just felt like, you know, it was finally time for me to do a fucking video. I'm probably not going to do videos, like, every game this year. It's not going to fucking happen. Like, next week, I'm not going to do a video for fucking Nicholls State. I may do something for other teams or whatever. I don't fucking know, but we'll have to see. The following week for Mizzou, I may do a fucking video on Mizzou. I don't fucking know. But rest assured, I will be doing a video for the Tennessee Hate Week. Oh, you bet your fucking ass I'll be on here for that. So, that's about it. Till next time, go Dawgs. Tennessee, you motherfuckers suck.